Good morning. I wanted to talk to you a little bit about what's going on in 3D. I have lots of news regarding the Illuminati and Kanye West. And then I want to talk a little bit about moving subjects about Rh negative and Rh positive blood and DNA potential. Give me 1 second. I'm going to post this and I'll get started. So I just found out my blood type, and it's something I kind of would encourage everyone to get into, because that way I can tell kind of like about my DNA potential, because I believe that people have different genetic strands or different amounts of DNA. Give me 1 second, I'm just going to post this in one more group. If I can find it. All right. So we are having lots of stuff go on, right? I don't know if everyone heard or saw that. The big news here will be the Kanye West meltdown. That's bigger than Standing Rock. That's on mainstream news everywhere. I was at work and I saw it on CNN. It's a big deal. Oh my God, right? And I would say this isn't like a usual publicity stunt where, you know, Kanye's kind of been going off the deep end for a while. It's nothing new, right? So people are kind of like just assuming he just went crazy again, right? Well, I would say either maybe he's waking up. Maybe he's starting to wake up and realize, you know, there's a few different theories. Maybe he's waking up, or maybe he's freaking out because his soul contract with dark forces is coming up and he's freaking out over it. People don't really know. But yes, this is really happening. He went to go to a concert and wouldn't sing, and people paid like $1,800 a ticket for these front row concert tickets. They were really mad. He was having a meltdown. Kim K, his manager, pretty much his PR wife, was freaking out with him. And basically, he was tied down, cuffed, and taken to a mental institution by the police. And a lot of people are speculating that probably the Illuminati's mad at him because he was freaking out and saying that Facebook and the media are, you know, controlling things. And then, and the Illuminati's probably really mad at him because he's black and he was saying he was pro-Trump. And, you know, that's a no-no. You're not allowed to do that, apparently. So I guess people are wondering what's going on with that. Because anyone who really, like, talks against Hillary is talking against the Illuminati, as you know. So you do know that there is control in very high places, and you're kind of like seeing a lot of craziness play out. Maybe he's waking up. Maybe he's starting to wake up, because people are going to wake up. People that you thought would never wake up. So it just goes to show you that you probably don't want these to be your role models. If you're looking at how the Kardashians treat the men that they date in their family, you probably don't want that for a role model. Look at, like, I don't know, Khloe Kardashian and Lamar. Like, what happened? You know, you probably just, you don't want those to be your role models. They're just not really good role models. And that's what I'm seeing all over the news. But I'm not seeing anything about Standing Rock or what's really going on in this country. I'm seeing Obama did some ceremony where he handed out like 20 freedom awards to some celebrities to distract people. These are all just huge distraction tactics. I also want to talk a little bit about, I just was talking to people in my family. I asked my siblings what their blood type was, because I was kind of like researching where people say that if you have Rh negative blood, then you probably have extraterrestrial blood, because what the negative and the positive mean after your blood type, like I'm O negative, which is rare. It's a universal donor type, but what's important isn't the type of blood, it's the negative or the positive sign after that, because that's the Rh factor. If you have Rh positive blood, then you have monkey DNA in you. So you have a different type of DNA. If you have Rh negative DNA, such as myself, you just have a different kind of genetic component. I don't have any of the monkey component in me. So I think that's becoming relevant. The reason why I think that's important, I just found out a different reason, but the reason why I think that's important is because we're trying to activate the DNA strands in our body. So it's really going to determine what your potential is by how many strands you have. There is some debate as to how many strands people actually have based on their blood type and different characteristics. Because as you know, Earth basically is a huge genetic experiment. We all have really mixed genetics at this point. But it's really going to matter on the ascension path. I just found out probably the reason it would matter more would be that if someone else went to have a kid with my twin flame, their body would probably attack it as alien and it wouldn't work. So when we do want to have kids, it will work because of my universal donor type. If I was like any other type, if I was like A or B, it wouldn't work. My body would attack a kid. We wouldn't be able to have one. So it really is going to matter like genetically by like how many strands you have. Type some questions below. I'm going to get like right into questions today. If you want to know something about your own life, type something really specific. I was in 3D yesterday and the entire sky was horrible. Like they were clearly spraying the sun out just in crisscross patterns the entire afternoon. I do live in Pittsburgh and they make chemtrails in this city, as in at Carnegie Mellon. That's where they experiment and make them and do all their work on them. So I really live in a heavy spray area. I've also heard that chemtrails are designed to target Rh negative blood types, and they really do devastating things to you. I'm pretty much, I feel like I'm immune to all these chemicals. Like I'm getting, my whole life I've just been chemicals poured upon me, so I feel like I'm kind of immune to it. But obviously it's not good to breathe. If you see them spraying the sky, try to stay inside, because it is aluminum. You will breathe it in and it will go to your brain. That's what causes all the Alzheimer's and dementia cases you're seeing now. So just be really aware of that, because I do believe it targets specific blood types, just the way they're made and designed. Basically, real quick, to go into what chemtrails and fluoride consist of, those are the chemicals in the sky and in your water. They are toxic waste, and to divert money so that they don't have to dispose of them properly, they just dump them in our water and in the sky, and then they pocket those couple billion dollars a year, and we're all being poisoned on a massive level. So it kind of has like a dual purpose, right? So just be really aware of that, because as you know, fluoride goes like a magnet to your third eye, and we really need to be looking at things from our third eye kind of perspective. We need our third eyes open, so just try to avoid these kind of chemicals. I know I'm going to be really careful if I go out to a restaurant. I'm not going to drink the water there. So just try to like be really aware of this stuff, because this is a physical process. We need our human bodies. I know this is like spiritual work that I'm doing and spiritual work I'm talking about, because I'm working on doing inner work in my life, which is reflecting to my body and all around me. This inner work I'm doing, it really will show in every aspect of your life. But we're talking about spiritual work, but you really need your physical body. We, by not taking care of ourselves, by not loving ourselves, by not being so nice to our bodies, we're really kind of changing the game in a negative capacity. So we need to go back to loving ourselves and taking care of our bodies, because we need them. I'm convinced I'm going to live like 5,000 years this life. So I feel like I really need this human body, and I need to keep it young. I believe that aging is in your mind. I believe that if you believe you're going to, you know, age when you're 70 and die at that age, great. You will probably create that with your mind. But I'm convinced that you can pretty much stay young forever if you choose to. So I don't know about all you guys. I maybe live in a different reality. I'm trying to get rid of these limits that I placed upon myself, because I just kind of, like you guys, was incarnated onto this plane, and I just picked up on everything my parents were teaching me, and I accepted their limitations. I took things at face value, and then I limited myself even more. So now I'm trying to get rid of these blocks, because I know that If I believe it enough, I can fly. Like, I would be able to. Like, I can do a reality test right now where I jump. Maybe I'm just not believing it enough. Maybe that's why I'm not flying. Like, but really, you can do these things if you believe it. If you don't believe in magic, you're not going to see any. I can be in the same place right now, and I can convince myself that this reality is it. This matrix is real. This is all that there is. That we're going to go and work, and we're on prison planet, and we're just going to work and die. And that's it. And when we die, you might, if you're lucky, you go to heaven, but you're probably going to get judged and go to hell. Like, I could believe that. I could really convince myself that this government has my best interest in mind, that I should continue to hand over my power to these institutions. But But if I do that, I'm missing out on the real world that's in the same place that's so tangible. I'm just handing away any power that I could conceive of. So it's really important that we start to focus not on this old paradigm that's not working. It's outdated. Like, it's just outdated. It's nothing personal. It's just not going to work for us. It's great that it worked for, you know, our parents and our grandparents, and that's great. But this system's outdated, and the only reason why is it's not serving us. If it was serving us, it would be great. It would still be, you know, fine. But it's not serving us. I'm convinced it never has been. And this is the time where it's being dismantled. And from inside out, like, we don't even really have to do a lot. You're just going to watch it. So just really try to focus on the new paradigm. I want to create a new world where I don't have to worry about these things. I'm working on living in abundance. I'm working on getting rid of these blocks that I placed on myself, like these regular blocks that keep us imprisoned here. Like, we feed into that illusion that money somehow gives us our value. Like, if you're doing good in life, if, you know, you have the two cars, the house, the wife, the kids, whatever it is, American dream, then you're great. You're doing great. Whereas maybe someone else isn't. That's not true. We all have our own paths, and it's kind of hard to put, you know, tell a fish in the bowl to go do the same thing as a dog. Train a fish like a dog, right? That's what we're trying to do with our kids. We're taking a box and trying to shove them in it, and they don't fit. So we really had to think outside the box. We really had to start embrace the differences, because when I was a kid, I was heavily indoctrinated. I had many gifts. I was very special. I was real empathic. I was this kid that could see auras and do cool things, and I was seeing spirits and, you know, whatever. But I was heavily reprimanded for that. All of that was drilled out of me, like in a very crazy capacity. Like, we're drilling those aspects out of our children. And really, is that what we want? Do we want our kids to grow up without any empathy? We want to take away those gifts, those qualities, because those are what makes people special. That's what makes people unique. We're kind of like taking away, basically, we're putting out their fire. Like we all have a spark in us. And some people that are, like, in a lot of darkness, they've lost that light. They don't have that light. Like, you can just tell when someone's enlightened and they have this bright light. And, like, I'm trying to share it with you guys. You can just tell, like, by the energy, whatever. And I feel like maybe some people just lost their spark and needed, you know, a little spark from someone else. We're supposed to do that. We're supposed to be these light workers that are uplifting this consciousness grid. And we can't do that if we're trying to fix the old system. It's not fixable. So just learn how to take a step back, watch, and figure out how you can help. Prayers and healing energy is and has been needed in Standing Rock. This is not something new. This has been going on daily for a while now. Please send healing energy and pray for them. It's just, 3D is about good and evil. It's where good and evil is fought. You have to understand that. So I can use my free will, and I can try to help people, and I can try to be of light. But someone else has just as much right to use their free will to embrace the dark side and to wreak havoc. Really. It's a realm where free will is fought. So you're kind of seeing that play out in a spiritual kind of way. And it's going to continue to play out. And it's going to continue to get louder in people's faces so that people can't ignore it anymore. This is all needed, though, because these people are going to wake up. I was interested in my blood type because I really believe that genetically some people are not built to be able to ascend or wake up. It sounds really crazy. They just don't have the genetic components. They're using the very basic, like, reptilian areas of the brain, and I just don't think they're wired for it. So I think that really does have a lot to do with it, on a deep level. Type some questions. I'm going to get to them now. Okay, I'm trying to read this. Hi, Marina. Hi, Todd. I'm very interested in finding out the real truth about the whole world without being lower vibrations. But the more I learn, the more I can overcome these illusions and have a deeper need to want to go work on my inner self for the greater good. Yeah, I feel like I know nothing. I really don't. I really do try to help, and I'm trying to share light. And I can do that because I'm full of divine love from my relationship with my twin flame. But on a deep level, I'm always learning. I was in dream school last night. Like, I'm learning a lot in my sleep, like in the dream state. I'm not able to retain everything, but on a subconscious level, I'm able to know what I learned. So it's able to help me. I also believe that all of the knowledge that I need is already in my DNA from my past life experiences. I already know all this stuff on a really deep level. That's why I'm not concerned about like going and Googling stuff and learning that way. I'm more concerned about unlocking my DNA so that I can recover more of my past life memories. So as I stay on my path and I keep going through this process, I'm only going to get more powerful, see more of, you know, who I really am. That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to tap into our authentic selves. I know that I'm a goddess. I've had hundreds of thousands of lives, not all of them here. I was a teacher in the past, and I'm still kind of like in a fog. Like, I still have this really crazy amnesia where my memories are starting to come back, but I can't remember everything. And it's kind of like a puzzle where you're trying to like put the pieces together. A lot of it comes from like a deep knowing feeling. You're just gonna feel like you're getting more and more connected and tuned in every day. This isn't an easy path. A long time ago, I had to put aside my life and any kind of thing I wanted to do with myself in my life. I had to kind of put away my will for the divine will. And it's very rewarding if you can see on the path, but you're looking at me of, I'm like pretty much, I woke up like a year ago and I've been heavily working on healing myself, on doing inner work every day for this past year. So you're seeing me like a year into it and you're seeing amazing results. In another year, it'll be even more amazing. So just stay on the path. I know a lot of people want to change like overnight, like, oh, well, I started eating healthy a week ago and I'm not losing weight and I don't see any results. I started eating healthy a week ago. Okay. Like, I've been doing this a week. Like, you really think that your body's gonna heal in that short amount of time? This is a year later. I easily need another year to heal myself. So we're really talking about healing on a deep level. Some people spend many lives working on this. It's not like, oh, I just did it in a life. Why do you think we come back so many times? So we're really talking about healing our inner selves. We have to look at the world from like a childlike perspective. With a completely open mind. We can't have any, oh, I want this to happen. I hope this happens. Oh, I think things will go like this. We just kind of have to put that aside. Because I might be teaching you all how you're not limited, that we're limitless. But yeah, I do have some limits. Like, I'm not the divine. Like, people say, oh, I'm going to turn into a god. Yeah, I'm a goddess, but I'm not the divine. So just really, have an open mind, because you're learning in every experience that you've ever had here. You just might not understand the level of it. I've been learning since I was a child important lessons that when you put them all together on a whole level, that's what makes up me, who I am. And that's what makes me really different from like my twin flame, who we have one soul, as in we are the same. But he had much different experiences this life, and so did I. So we're very different people, and we're trying to balance both aspects of ourself. That's what we're learning. You guys all had to learn how to balance your own selves, because ultimately the goal is to be reunited with your twin flame and to balance the divine feminine and divine masculine. So you have to remember that every person you've ever dated is an aspect of the divine. We're all aspects of the divine having a human experience. And some of those relationships didn't go great, right? So if we can't even get along with everyone, we have to learn how to kind of get along with everyone. And we're not really good at that. So we're learning how to be nicer people, and every relationship has been practiced for that ultimate one. That's what we're here to learn. We're here to learn unconditional love, which is very different than the typical 3D paradigm, which is about control dramas and controlling each other. And, oh, I have to be with this person because, like, it's just very different. There's no strings attached. You give each other your time because you love each other. It's just, it's not conditional, which My relationships of the third dimension were very conditional. Even with my family, I felt like they were very conditional. A lot of my friendships feel very fake now. They were very conditional, fake. They didn't have real connection. Now, I have to have that real connection. That's why, like, I spend, when I'm not working, me and my twin flame spend every minute together. Because we have a very deep connection. It's very heart-centered. It's very from our heart chakras. And it's just amazing. So when I go around people that I don't have a real connection with, it feels kind of fake. So I'm really working on building those heart-centered relationships back up with my family. But a lot of you guys are feeling like, okay, well, my karma ended with my family. I'm kind of distancing myself from it or walking away or whatever, because you do have that choice. And then you have to remember that we have soul contracts that we kind of like, they kind of lead us in life. And a lot of you guys have contracts that you didn't realize you even signed. And it's affecting you on an energetic level. I would advise everyone of looking into like what kind of contracts they have left and getting rid of any that aren't serving them. Because those can really keep you tied here. We're really trying to liberate our soul. And you're seeing a lot of these celebrities with bad soul contracts freaking out. Like Kanye West, Miley Cyrus, I'm seeing a theme. Because they know they have a dark soul contract. And I wouldn't want to be the one to pay for that on a deep karmic level. I wouldn't want it. It wouldn't be worth any amount of money to me. So it's not like you can buy someone's soul per se, but you can wrap yourself up in a soul contract that isn't good. So, which can keep you trapped. So I don't think that's worth any amount of money, or fame or whatever it is that they're promised. It just really isn't worth it. You're going to find out that you can go ahead and manifest whatever you want. But those aren't things, those are ego drives. Those aren't things that will fulfill you. The only thing that is going to fulfill you is to raise your vibration and tap into higher dimensions and to integrate your body with your higher self. Because when you're living from those lower aspects, that ego personality, it's not going to be ever as fulfilling as when you're embodying your higher self. You're able to perceive vast amounts of information from the universe. I'm one with everything. There's just amazing benefits to it. My life used to be very depressing. I used to have a lot of anxiety. Now my life is just completely different. It's just fulfilling in a different kind of way. I know that I might not be making big changes, but I'm making small changes in people. I feel that when you're watching this, that you're getting activated. You're getting some kind of message directly from my third eye. You're getting a download, not of me talking, but just from like looking at me and being around my energy. So it's just, I'm learning how to like, I can go out and help, like what I could do to really make a change or help. And why not? We're on Facebook anyway, right? We're on Facebook all the time anyway. I may as well use it to reach people. So a lot of you guys are just kind of figuring that out. We have to be on that real path. And so many of you are. You're seeing signs all around you. You're seeing magic. You're seeing synchronicities. You're just kind of like opening your mind to, wow, the world isn't at all like we were taught. And there's unlimited potential. There's unlimited possibilities. And I can just do something amazing with my life now. Like, I know I can do whatever I want. I feel like me and my twin flame have unlimited potential here. Like, we can really create anything that we want. And it's really amazing to me. So the best thing that you can do is spiritual work, work on your inner self. I have a deep feeling that people need healing on a deep level. Everyone, especially when I'm doing these videos, I already picked up like 3 blocks in my heart chakra and possibly one in my third eye. I'm starting to feel it. I really feel an effect from doing these, which should make some of you guys feel better watching me like I'm taking on some of those blocks for you guys. I'm trying to help. But really, you have to meditate, you have to go within, and that's where you're going to find the answers. It's not going to be anywhere outside of yourself. You're going to find the answers by going within, and that will create a ripple effect, which will unlock your DNA and help you on your path. So start meditating. I don't sit there and meditate per se, but I do use other forms of things as meditation. Like I meditate while I'm at work, basically. I'll zone out, whatever. You can do other things. You can do yoga, you can do kickboxing, you can do other kind of like exercise. prioritize things, whatever, where you can do stuff on autopilot and go within. Just really try to get back to your real self. We've been going through life trying on different roles. And if you're anything like me, none of those roles were me. This is me that you're looking at. And it took me a while to find myself and get back to the authentic me, because I was kind of like trying on so many roles, whatever. But we're trying to find our authentic self. We've been going through this process since we've been born, getting rid of things that aren't serving us as we go along. And I have a little bit of advantage. On a different note, someone was saying that, like, we all have light and dark in us. I really believe that. But I had to conquer my own darkness. I have a lot of experience with the shadow world. And by that, I mean on Earth as well as in other astral planes that aren't so great. I have done a lot of shadow work. But really, when I do that, it's myself. It's my shadow side that I know very well. It's my shadow side I had to conquer. It wasn't the world's shadow side. It was my shadow side. So everyone kind of has a different kind of different shadow side of themselves. We're really just trying to conquer that. I jumped right in. I had a lot of grief that threw me right along. I went right down the rabbit hole in a negative capacity, and it took me a long time to come back out. But I had to do that. I had to go fight my own darkness to find my light. So that's just part of the process. I had to go through the dark night of the soul too, where it was kind of depressing and I felt real bad about my life. And then I figured out, well, everyone is me, so it's myself I'm having a war with. And I kind of got over it. But, and then I was going to say one more thing on that. But yeah, we're just really trying to conquer those aspects of ourselves. That's how we find our light, is to, I would hate that about, like, the light worker group, no offense, but they would like delete anything. If anyone said anything about darkness, they would like delete it and censor it. And I hate that, because I don't think we should be being censored if we're spreading the truth. And that's an aspect that I know you see me and I'm like, oh great, I'm in love and I'm of light. But I had to go through that darkness more than anyone, I assure you. So it's something that's part of this enlightenment process. So I don't like how people ignore it and act like it doesn't exist. Darkness is very prevalent. I've already had a negative entity attack this morning. I fight darkness. Like, I'm a warrior. I'm an indigo. So I actually fight this darkness for a lot of people. So I think it's amazing if you're like a crystal and you can pretend darkness doesn't exist. But we all have different roles, and there are like angels that straight fight demons in darkness. There are those light workers that do that too. So I don't think we should ignore it. It's very real and it's very around us. And not to mention, this is the time of year when darkness is more prevalent. So sage your house is extra. Another topic, this is what I was just remembered. Another topic I wanted to touch base on was a dream I had last night, where basically we're being indoctrinated and pushed into these religions and races and divided. We're basically being separated and divided since birth. I had this dream where it was like some kind of school, and there were these little kids, and they were probably like 6 years old or maybe seven, a little bit older, little kids. And it was like their recess or something. And I walked through the classroom and out to the side, right? And there was like a bunch of students, and they were Muslim, and they were all in a group right there. And then there was a little Christian girl I walked by. And then there was another group of religion playing outside. We're being separated. We're being put in these boxes that aren't real. Like, we're all people. It doesn't matter what our belief systems are. And these religions are what's causing all this war and fighting and whatever. That's why it's being pushed on us. We have to get to a point where we don't need these control systems. And by these control systems, I mean religions and politics. We don't need them. Like, we never had a need. We don't need these leaders. We don't need these rulers. We can rule ourselves. We don't need it. We all have that intuition, that internal guidance, that divine guidance. We don't need someone outside of us telling us what to do and harvesting us energetically and whatever's going on. We don't need it. These churches, they don't have the answers anymore. They might have had some light a long time ago. Maybe some of them. I don't even think the ones in my country did, but maybe in other countries, like in Tibet and stuff, they really did. They might have had that light at one point in time, but they're all distorted. They're not going to teach you enlightenment. You're going to have to go within and do that inner work yourself. And if you're like me, you're going to find bits and pieces of the truth mixed amongst the religions, where you're you're able to take out what's true and what's not and kind of put it together yourself. I would say my views kind of touch on every religion there is, but I'm not going to be oppressed by them. I'm not going to go kneel down every Sunday to them. So I'm not going to pray to them. We're slaves. I don't know if you know that. I don't care how much money you have, how great you think you have it. You are a slave on Prison Planet, just like me. So you're not any different. I don't care if you think you're at the top of the pyramid. There is no top, like, per se. So no, we're all slaves here. And we need to liberate ourselves from Prison Planet. And we're going to do that by not handing over our power to institutions outside of ourselves. We're going to learn how to use that power correctly so that we can have more of it and we can evolve past this perpetual state of war, fighting, whatever it is. That separation isn't even real. Me and you are deeply connected, like deeply connected. Every person watching this, there's, I don't know, 48 people watching. I am deeply connected with every person watching. Every person is gonna watch this video. You're being drawn to me for a reason. I'm your soul family. It's not random. We didn't incarnate alone here like everyone believes. Oh, I was alone my whole life. I was never alone. I had everyone around me. I just couldn't see. I couldn't see. I was looking with my eyes. I couldn't see because my third eye was closed. So we're deeply connected, and we really have to get past that. Because we're taught these things as children. I just really think we need to reevaluate what we're teaching our kids in these schools and these institutions, because we're letting the government raise our children. In a deep kind of way, you are going to work and you're not going to be able to watch your kids. I don't care. Not your whole life. You're not going to be able to. We're on Prison Planet. And you're going to hand them over to a daycare and then eventually a school. Most people. And then a school. They're going to go to school their whole lives. You're handing your children over for the government to raise. How good did that work when it was us? Not very good. I had to unlearn everything I ever learned in school. And yeah, we're talking college too. I had to unlearn all of that and relearn the truth. So it's not helping in any capacity. I think we just really need to be careful. Like, is that what we want for our future? Is that really what we want now? Hi, Milena. We're amazing, beautiful souls. Yes, every soul is perfect and divine, as in flawless. So I know we feel like when we're here, like, oh my God, I have so many flaws. I don't know, my skin's not that great today. Whatever, I can probably just think of a few, you know? Maybe my stomach's not that flat, whatever it might be. We all perceive that we have these flaws, but really our souls are the pure divine essence. So it's really amazing. We're learning that we're placing these things on ourselves and that we're so hard on ourselves. We just really need to have more self-love. Happy birthday, Robin. Then I have to think of the date. I think you're a Scorpio. My mom's birthday would have been like in a week. She was Sagittarius. I'm pretty sure you're a Scorpio. Happy birthday. That's amazing. If you want to know something, just ask something specific, like a specific question. Yep, you're just imagining these things or making them up. Yeah, I know I might appear to be nuts to certain people, like when I'm asking my family weird questions, like, by the way, what's your blood type? I know I might appear to be like a little unraveled. But I assure you, it's the people that are asleep that are crazy, and I'm pretty much one of the few sane people. So those of us that are awake, we really just have kind of an advantage. I know it sounds crazy, but I think people that are asleep and living unconsciously and on autoplay with all that anxiety and worry and, oh my God, I think this is going to happen, freaking out like a wind-up doll or wind-up toy or whatever. I just think that's crazy. I really do. I think I was living crazy for half my life. I really think it's crazy. So, it's really easy for those people to judge, but their life should be perfect then, right? If I'm so crazy, their life should be perfect and mine should be a mess, but I'm pretty sure it will be the opposite way around at this point. So obviously I've tapped into something and I'm doing something right because I've completely changed my own life, like completely changed it. As I raise my vibration, the world I'm seeing is changing around me. like on a physical level, and it's really changing things. I know that every day I'm going to continue to get more and more high vibe. I'm like vibrating right now. Like I feel really good, like high vibe, vibrating, whatever. I can feel it. It's stuff I can feel. So I might not be able to measure it so good with my EMF or, you know, the device on your phone to measure your vibration. I haven't found a way to tangibly measure it, but I happen to know it's real and that I've connected to something very real, and that the more source energy I can hold in my body, the better things are going to be for me. You know, it's very healing. It's very good for manifesting, whatever. It's just going to totally clean out your whole body on a cellular level. So my goal is to hold more and more energy. So much I can't even hold it all. I'm trying to give it away to you guys. Like, give you a little boost. Like, so anyways, yeah, that's the goal. I think everyone else is crazy. Lloyd. Hi, Lloyd. Just to start, me and my twin flame are a big fan of yours. We love your music. That's gonna take off very soon because people are gonna shift the type of music they're listening to. So maybe if it didn't do that well in the past or whatever, that's gonna shift. That's gonna change. And you're gonna do big things with this music because we need to go back to a society where people are working based on their gifts and their skills and their talents. We've become so left-brained or analogical or whatever. We need to go back to embracing these kind of lost things like arts and science and stuff. So it's amazing you're on your point when you kind of talk about connecting to your inner self, becoming one with all things. Yeah. I love it. And so it is. Yeah, it's really amazing to be connecting with all of you guys. It's kind of like meaningful connections after having those kind of not real connections for so long. I see so many people living from a heart-centered place and putting their all out there. And it might be like slow at first or, you know, kind of like, oh, I've been doing this a week. Why haven't I ascended? But you have to just kind of do this every day and stay on the path. And every day you're going to get a little closer. So a year later, I'm getting better and closer, but I'm not there yet. So it's just kind of a slow process. Stay on your path and don't let anyone tell you that that path isn't right, because that's your path. It's just different. So, believe it or not, if I had been you and I had your experiences in your life, I would be you to a T. We all have that same kind of divine energy blueprint. We really are all one on a deep level. So it's really important that we don't judge people based on their path. So when people say, you know, you're acting crazy and I think I'm normal and you're crazy, that's kind of judgmental, which will lower your vibration. It's just kind of like a trap where you can get stuck in that kind of thinking. Just be careful not to judge anyone, because I assure you that you could switch places with anyone here and you would be them if you had their experiences. So we don't really know what people have been through. Just try to have more compassion, because we have to become one with everything and everyone. That's going to be the key. There has to be balance, because if not, the cycle of life falls apart. There does have to be balance. By the way, I know everyone wants to just get rid of this darkness real fast. Me too, right? Let's just vibrate out of here with it. Let's just vibrate out of here with it. But that polarity is needed for people to learn. So without that darkness, without that evil, darkness, good, bad, whatever, you wouldn't have a good place to learn. That's how we're becoming to be light workers. So that polarity is needed. And it's not just going to be like, oh, I don't think the third dimension's needed anymore. I think that, like, oh, it's just going to disappear. No, like, even when that does happen, when we like have a shift apart, that's going to go, the third dimension is going to go to another planet to learn for like another 75,000 years. It's not like it just disappears. Those people will catch up. And so if people are choosing to stay asleep, they don't want to ascend, they don't want to wake up this life, that's their choice. Eventually they will catch up. So you don't have to like worry about your family members that might just be like less evolved than you. I know that, that parents would like to think that they're the teachers, but the children come to teach the parents. So I know a lot of people, their parents are less evolved than them, just like your kids are going to be more evolved than you every time. So it's kind of like the reverse. So those that are like less evolved, choosing to be trapped here, whatever, they will catch up. Just have more compassion for these people. Have so much compassion for them, because this is really an important time. Like, it's time now. Like, you don't have that much time. I don't like putting dates on things, But you really need to start doing this inner work now, because you don't want to be at the point where your vibration's too low and you can't raise it that fast. So you have to be raising your vibration slowly now to match the Earth's if you want to make this major jump. Like, you really just have to. Tomorrow maybe I'll wake up, my vibration will be like way higher. It won't be a lot higher. It's going to gradually increase every day, but it's something I have to work at doing every day. I have to watch what I put in my body, drink a lot of water, the basics that I'm always trying to drill into you guys. That will really help. So I'm working at doing it every day. It's those that are doing nothing that all of a sudden their vibration is going to be so low compared to the Earth's, they're not going to be able to catch up. They're going to be screwed. So just really work at raising your vibration now. The more water you can drink, the better. That's the thing with these chemtrails. Basically, they dehydrate you and then they lower your vibration by making you grumpy. Basically, in a basic kind of way, that's really what they're doing. They're dehydrating you, which is going to lower your vibration, which could lower the vibration entirely. Entire cities, right? Make people irritable, whatever. So basically, just try to drink more water, stay hydrated, because really there's just other factors into it. But there has to be balance in everything. You're going to learn that your soul is composed of two units, male and female. I am only half of that. Like, so I have to be able to be in perfect peace, love, and harmony with my twin flame for this to work. If we're ever fighting or not getting along or in disharmony, it would totally destroy what I'm working for, because I wouldn't be able to manifest properly or be able to do what I'm supposed to. So I have to be in peace, love, and harmony all the time, which, as you might know, anyone who's been in any kind of relationship, whether it be a twin flame or not, that's very hard to do. We're learning how to do that. And we're really learning how to balance ourselves first. So work at trying to balance yourself, because you're going to have to do that with another person. You will reach that point of completion. Good morning, Jody. Siobhan, what do you want to know specifically? I know how you feel, Melina. Why do I keep seeing so many faces? I can just be laying down and I start seeing figures and faces. I'm still trying to comprehend what I am or what I'm here to do. Sometimes I just feel angry and depressed. Well, I used to be very angry and depressed at the whole world, personally. It was just kind of in my programming. So I would say just be really aware of that, because it seems like you're an indigo. So you're kind of like a warrior, a fighter. You're going to be against any kind of like corruption, anything unfair or unjust, because deep down you know that we're all equal. Like, I'm equal to you. There's no one above or below you. So like, me and my twin flame, we're equals. Like I'm not better than him. He's not better than me. We're complete equals in every way. So that's all how people all are. Just try to get past that anxious depression phase. Try to let it go. If you take medications, I'm always telling you it will just prolong that state. So try to avoid any kind of toxins and start meditating. It will get rid of that anxiety, that anger, those lower vibrations completely. Like, it will completely clear your body out. Everyone needs to find a way to keep their chakras open all the time. Okay, I don't know what that entails for you, but that's the goal. If I have a blocked chakra, the energy is going to kind of, if I have a blocked heart chakra, it's just going to stop kind of flowing right there. You know, get muddled up. It's not going to work. So we have to be really aware that we're keeping our chakras open. The best way to do that is meditation. And going into nature is very helpful too. So just try to embrace it. Don't be afraid of seeing visions. It's something I've been doing for a really long time. Don't be afraid of it. Embrace it. Because any kind of fear will kind of greatly impact your experience. You're learning how to play around with these things. That's how I became like a Vance in the dream world, just playing around with it, just jump in and play around with it. But you can do certain things for protection. Like, I tell everyone to sage their house, because sage will kill bacteria in the air. Like, it just totally purifies the energy and makes it have a better energy. It's going to uplift the vibration in your house. Sage your house. You can pray to put you and your house in white light. This is something that most of you guys should be doing. Maybe that's something they should be teaching people in these churches, right? Let's see. Good morning, Julie. Sending you some love back. Sending you all some love. I have dreams of not being loved. Like, people dislike me in my dreams. I don't know where it came from. Well, then you're not loving yourself. Because every person or entity coming to you in a dream is a different aspect of yourself. We're kind of like, people are like mirrors to teach us about ourselves. So if you've ever had a problem with anyone in the real world or dream world, it's really a problem with yourself. So we're learning how to love ourselves and get along with all aspects of ourselves. I have some pretty not that great ones, but I transmuted them. That's where alchemy comes into play. So maybe I found out I have some really shitty qualities, like I can't really think. I don't know. You have to pick out those qualities. You have to know yourself good enough to know, okay, I don't like this quality about myself. Maybe I don't even know. I can't think of anything right now. You just have this bad quality. You have to transmute it to a good quality. You have to get rid of it completely. Like, say, you're going to be learning things like, I can't think of anything. I don't know. I used to smoke. I had to quit that. It's not like I can ascend with cigarettes. You have to get rid of these bad habits. Like, I don't know. I maybe used to drink. I would never drink again. You have to take any kind of negative qualities that you have, become aware of them, and conquer them. As in, conquer them completely. Not like, oh, maybe I won't lie today. Like, no, all the time you're not going to do that. like maybe I'll be a nicer person. You have to work at it all the time. You have to learn how to become aware of this dark aspects of yourself and to get rid of them completely. You have to learn how to transmute them. We're all becoming alchemists where we can take something negative and make it positive. That's our job as light workers. We should all be really amazing at that. Because as light workers, that's really what our training is in. Taking negative situations and making them positive. So just really work at that. Also work at becoming lucid in your dreams so that you can control them. I think it's amazing that you're remembering your dreams, though. Start to try to do that more and more. I'm having a problem where I forget what I'm learning in the dream world. I'm not able to take it back here. I know I'm able to retain it on a subconscious level, but I'm not able to consciously retain it. So I'm trying to work at retaining the information I'm receiving in the dream world, retaining it here, because in the dream world, there isn't free will at play. So we're able to be taught a lot of things. Whereas here, it's not as easy. So we just learn a lot in our dreams. A lot of us go to dream school and all sorts of things. So it's really amazing. Try to retain it and try to work on loving yourself more and taking better care of yourself. Sorry. You're going to find that with this ascension path, you're just going to be able to do things easier. Like, you're really going to, if you stay on this path, things will come easier to you. Like, whereas I used to have a lot of anxiety and nervousness because I was very empathic and I was always taking on other people's feelings and emotions, and it would be very hard for me to tell the difference between my emotions and theirs. Now I'm kind of like a Jedi. I can be careful about what I'm taking on from other people. I can kind of control it. So those of you that are empathic, you're going to have to learn how to stop being that sponge that picks up everything, that just is letting the whole world filter through you. You're learning how to control that so that you can let in what you pick and choose. So you're kind of playing with your power. I had to go through like the whole empath narcissistic relationship to kind of grow into my power. And it was very devastating. So if anyone's had kind of any of these like relationship things, dramas, you would know. But that's what taught me my power. So a lot of people that are just waking up are realizing that life has an energy component to it, and that maybe I'm being harvested energetically by my relationship, my job, whatever it may be, society. And you're kind of like learning how to preserve your energy on a different level, because you really need your energy. I saw a really funny post from Shyla where she says, it's all right, take my energy, I have unlimited energy. Oh, can I get some more guys for my friends? Like, really, we really like to think we have unlimited potential, like our unlimited energy, like, oh, I'm tapped into this source energy, it's unlimited. But really, I know on a deep level that I only have so much energy every morning, and I should be kind of careful with it. You're just becoming more careful of who you choose to give your energy to, because these energy vampires are kind of, it's a kind of a dual idea. Oh, my energy's being sucked dry. Well, you're handing it away. You're throwing it away. So maybe you should be more careful with your energy, because that's part of your power, that chi energy, that you might need it. I need my energy to heal you guys. So just be really more aware of your energy. Mm. All women are goddesses. Exactly. Wow. Yeah, you nailed it. Yes. I was a goddess that a lot of you guys might remember in Egypt, though. I was a goddess that was notable in my past life, but that's not me really now. So I'm on this role, this life. I'm someone different, but we all are goddesses on a deep level, not just the ones that came from space and were perceived as gods and goddesses. We all are on a deep level. We're realizing that we are aspects of the divine having a human experience. Oh, God. Okay, so what's my view on gay people? Do you believe that twin flames can come back as different genders that continue past together? Okay, I'm sure I just jump right into every topic. Okay, let me go there. This is such a multifaceted question. There's so much going on with aura manipulation and how people feel in their bodies. Let's just say that I've had many lives. I've been male and female. If I had most of my lives as a male and I came into this body as a female, I'm sure I would identify as a male. It would be very hard for me to adjust, like if you've had more than half your lives as that gender. So a lot of people are feeling that kind of, you know, where they should be adjusting to that experience that they chose, you know, that sex, they're not. And you have to understand there's a lot going on with television and government stuff and aura manipulation that's causing a lot of people to jump on this bandwagon. But a lot of people that are having any kind of things go on like that, a lot of those people have a blocked red and orange chakra. And that is something that can be healed with a lot of inner work. Now, you're not going to be incarnated as same sex with your twin flame ever, but you can meet someone in your soul family or your soulmate, you know, soulmate or soul family, and you can have a lifelong great relationship with them, I'm sure, and be same sex. These are members that we find throughout our lives. So people, I'm sure, can have many soulmate relationships being the same sex because we find and attract our soul family. But you're not going to have a twin flame union. That's where you incarnate the same sex. You're not going to. I know a lot of people teach that, like, oh, it's about unconditional love, and people come to break these barriers. It's just not the way it really works. There's just a lot of things behind the scenes I could really keep elaborating with that affect these kind of things. So, I don't know. I know a lot of people that go through these kind of issues. I've had every chakra broken on me in my life, but it is ultimately something that can be really, like, depressing on a deep level, because you know that it's kind of like a trap that's keeping you ultimately from being happy. So it's a very confusing issue. Anyone going through these issues has my empathy. I have a deep understanding of many of these things because I've experienced a lot of them, but it's very disorienting. You're not going to have that same sex relationship with your flame, though. But you can have, many people can be with their soulmates their whole lives. I would have been with my soulmate my whole life if my twin flame wasn't here and I wasn't destined for things with him. So these kind of soulmate relationships are equally as amazing. They're a lot easier too. They're definitely a lot easier than the twin flame relationship, which you have to evolve very rapidly. Like, I woke up and then had to absorb everything my twin flame had already learned, and he had to learn that, take everything off of me, like through osmosis. You kind of had to, like, rapidly catch up on each other's experiences, and you're going to evolve very rapidly. So there's a lot of work that goes with that. You're going to see everything you like and don't like reflected back to you about yourself. So it's really just going to, like, evolve both parties very rapidly. Whereas a soulmate relationship is more like your soul family, they're familiar. You might have had past relationships with them in the past. But ultimately, you're not made for that person. Ultimately, we were all only made for one person, which explains a lot of things, because I had a really bad time with relationships. I don't know about you guys. They just didn't work out in the past because I wasn't made for any of those people. I'm only made on a deep level for one person. So the things that probably would annoy someone about me or whatever they would like, it doesn't matter, because I'm made in every way for my twin flame, as in every way compatible, down to our blood types, down to every star in our natal chart is completely compatible and made for each other. You can tell on a deep level, down to our blood type for when we have kids. Like, these things were all planned out and picked out and orchestrated prior to coming here. So you really, the trick is to reunite with your twin flame is to go within, go back to source, and to love yourself more. When you can love yourself completely and complete yourself as a person, that's the key. So it's really amazing. That is our mission here, is love. And it's divine love. It's a different kind of love. So let's see. Am I almost done? None of us are. I'm not. No, I don't think any of us are. I know everyone's saying, oh, there's another There's another 5 months. Melanie, you're still working on your throat chakra. I see like three of you guys are. I would say that's the chakra of the day. The throat chakra. We are working on speaking our truth. I'm like coughing it up already. I prefer to wait till after the video, but you're working on your throat chakra. You're not almost done. Do I feel like I'll ever be almost done? Probably not. I've been going through this process for a while now, many lives. So it's kind of like a process we're just going through. I don't feel like we're almost done. We're getting there and we're getting closer. But we have much work to do. We have much healing to do. We really do on a collective level. So just really work at uplifting yourself. Because the more people that are uplifting themselves and helping raise consciousness, we're going to expand it. We're talking about expanding and raising our consciousness. So we're basically trying to open our minds to more possibilities. We're working on expanding. Just really keep working at raising your vibration because it's going to do amazing things. I think it's really fascinating. A lot of people are talking about grids and grid work. And I think it's really fascinating that we do... Our earth is covered in these ley lines. This is what these ancient monuments are built on, like the pyramids and Stonehenge. They're all on these sites. But us as light workers, we're strategically placed out on this grid. And we're going to turn it on for the first time ever. And I'm really excited about that because I know we're so strategically placed on it. Just to say, I did have someone message me about contrails and chemtrails. I'm going to stand by. Planes don't make contrails in the way that people want to explain it. And that they do not explain these chemtrails. If you would like to see me furtherly, I have some crazy pictures of our sky here. It's not even explainable. I'm sorry. I don't think that planes are going to be able to fly in that grid pattern. I just don't think it will be safe to be flying back and forth like that. If you want to say that's multiple flights picking up, I'm going to stand by anything I say. If you don't agree, that's amazing. Please look into it. I really hope you don't agree with me. I hope you kind of open your mind to it. But I'm going to stand by that. And I'm also going to say, and then they mentioned flat earth. The earth is not flat, but it's not round. That shoots down both of these theories. It's almost like a concave, like a dome. So just to let you guys know, I don't get into all that stuff. I'm more into like that grid on the earth. I told this person, I think it's amazing they're spreading the sky. And I think it's amazing because that's the worst thing on a planetary level that's happening to us here. And so because of that, it was a game changer. It allowed extraterrestrial life to intervene because of the things happening here. Because this is a place where free will is played out, right? A planet of free will. Well, when they're spraying the sky like that, it's actually doing something really bad because Gaia, it's like impending on Gaia's free will. So when the Earth is not allowed to respond, when its free will is taken away, it's like the worst thing they've ever done here. So just to let you know, I'm kind of glad that it's getting so crazy because now there's extraterrestrial life that can intervene and help us. So it's really amazing. A lot of people are working on raising their vibration. And when you can do that, you can communicate with higher dimensional beings, entities such as angels, aliens, Pleiadians, all sorts of higher dimensional beings. So we're really trying to work at raising our vibrations so that we can communicate with these entities and hear them and help here on Earth. So this is something that's done subconsciously. I know a lot of people with Rh negative blood have had alien abduction experiences. That's a group that is heavily regulated from space. So a lot of these have had these kind of experiences. A lot of us can't remember all of them. There's a lot of memory wiping that goes along in the dream world, during abductions, whatever. So just keep an open mind. I don't claim to know the truth. I have found my own truth from going within. I found what resonates with me and what works for me. I think everyone has to find their own path and their own truth, though. I don't think that you're going to be able to listen to me and completely agree with everything I'm saying. Are you kidding? I have a lot of people, I watch their videos, I don't agree with everything they say, but I think they do amazing work. So we really have to kind of find our own truth, and everyone's going to have a different world right here. same place, different world. But I despite I might disagree with people, I don't find the need to go attack them. So I don't know. Some of the best things I get attacked on really fuel for great discussions, though, so I love it. Go ahead. Attack away. But I really think that we have to get past a point where you're going to really argue over you don't agree with something when none of us know for a fact. We're just kind of going on, like, how we feel and what resonates with us. But you didn't need proofs when your governments were telling you things, did you? You didn't need any evidence for that, right? You guys just take everything Obama says at face value. So, good luck waking up your friends. I think that that's part of the problem, not the solution. So, I don't know. It's just making me kind of crazy. Just really, if you don't agree with someone, you don't have to go straight attack them, yell at them, cuss at them, you know, call them a cunt, whatever it is. You don't have to, like, go to that extreme. If you're feeling that need, that if you're being triggered to, like, go attack someone's views, maybe you should go within and look at yourself a little deeper. Because you're attacking yourself on a deep level, which is never good. The brain mirror neurons in your brain can't perceive it any differently. So we all just really, we might not agree with everyone. Everyone's entitled to their own beliefs at this point. We're done pushing Christianity on people and killing them for not believing in it. We're over. That era is over. like I can believe whatever I want. I can say whatever I want. I can go on Facebook Live. If you don't like it, you can just change the channel. It's amazing that you have free will, that you can turn away. You don't have to listen to me. That's the amazing thing. So just really go ahead. I want people to question things. I want people to go, you know, sign off of here and go look into this stuff on their own. So I didn't learn everything that I know from one source. My journey took me everywhere, and I really invite everyone to do the same. But you'll notice a theme. If you're, like, watching these kind of videos, you're gonna notice a theme. Like, oh, maybe she's not so crazy because there's so many people with the same kind of views and the same thing going on. So you're really gonna learn how to differentiate between this stuff. Like, there's a lot of fake information out there, but there's a lot of real information that's gonna resonate very deeply with you. I take it as a compliment when I get attacked at my work. I must be doing something right if people want to shut me down. So we're really just trying to learn how to balance those aspects in all of us. And we're learning how to get along better with everyone. It doesn't mean that I can be nice to my flame and be mean to any of you guys. I have to learn how to, I have to apply that to every aspect of my life. I have to be nice to everyone. So we're all just kind of, like, learning how to get along again. You're crying again, Maddie. Anxiety, I can feel it. Like, I'm like, I can feel it. Try not to go back to Xanax. Don't go back to Xanax. And we call them mind erasers because they really erase your mind, as in make you forget things. They basically wipe your memory in an odd way. That's probably the worst medications, benzodiazepine. Anyone can really go on. If you're having really bad anxiety, I would recommend CBD. I tell everyone that. If you have the money, try CBD because it's amazing for anxiety. Try going into nature. Try getting outside. You're too cooped up. It's freezing out here. It's 30 degrees and probably gonna snow this weekend. But if you can, if you live in a warmer climate, try to get outside. If you don't, start meditating. That will get rid of any anxiety you have. Someone we know, Carlos, was saying that meditating saved his life and got rid of all those lower emotions like anxiety and whatever. So that's really amazing. It can just save your life in a non-medical kind of way. You're seeing synchronicities like crazy, and you find feathers and pennies, and I got really excited when I heard feathers because those are from your family from the other realm. And you're going to notice that if you have loved ones that have died, they're going to start to leave you things. Like, my mom leaves me feathers. She leaves me all sorts of things when I go outside, like butterflies and stuff. So you're starting to at least see the signs. There's people that maybe they would see the feather and they kick it and walk right by, right? At least you're starting to open your eyes and recognize these signs. So every time I look at the clock, it's like 11:11, 1:11, 3:33. We get hit with number codes. I'll be driving and there's a license plate with a number code right in front of me. We're going to start to see this stuff more and more. There's magic in our everyday lives. I know we've been taught they're mundane and boring, but there's so much magic around us. And you're going to know you're on the right path because for so long, we were fighting the universe and it was kind of throwing us around and we were responding to it. And it wasn't pleasant. now we're on our right path. We're living authentically, or you should be. You're living authentically, and you're going to start to see signs, and the universe is going to help you. You're having a smoother time. Everything's just easier. You're seeing magic to remind you that you're on the path. That's really amazing. I'm going to do some cards. I want to do something different. I want to do some cards to finish up. I'm getting ready for 5 days off with my twin flame, which is really amazing. Today's his last day of work, so I'm very excited about that. Yesterday was mine. I am available for readings today and chakra openings. If anyone wants any, you can PM me, or you can go to sparksofdivinelighthealing.com. I'm going to go down the list, leave your name or something. I'll start with the people who already posted questions, and I'll draw you guys a card. Something new, right? We had to go to his family's for Thanksgiving, so that's going to take away one of those days. So it's like 4 days off, but still, it's really amazing. So I'm excited about that. Let's see. Marina, I can't say names good. Marina Gordon. Oh, authority. All right. So Marina, we're dealing with authority. We're dealing with a lot of authority right now. That seems to be the trend anyway. We're dealing with these corrupt systems that aren't serving us. A lot of us are getting pulled into these authority struggles, especially with Standing Rock and what's going on. Basically, this authority systems are not really serving us. And a lot of you are already aware that they're dismantling, they're crumbling on their own. But a lot of people have been pulled into these systems throughout their entire lives, mostly indigos. It's your job to dismantle these systems. That is your job. That is your soul path. You're going to destroy these systems. You're going to pull them down. And you're going to start by getting rid of any systems that are running in your own life in that 3D paradigm. That, you know, I have no power. I have no money. I have no power. These blocks that we put up, you're really going to work on getting rid of them. And everyone is equal. There is no authority. This authority has no authority over us. I am equal to Obama. I am equal to Trump. I am equal to this authority. They have no more power than I do. So just kind of realize that. We're all just kind of realizing that. Right. Todd. Fertility. You're going to have a baby. Well, okay, I kept on pulling the fertility card, but in a different deck for everyone. And when I see fertility, I don't think of a baby. It sounds really crazy. I think more like of abundance, like you're coming into abundance. Like fertility meant abundance in Egypt. So I see this more like you're coming into abundance, that your life was very limited financially, and you lived a very not abundantly most of your life. Now things are changing, and you're going to really start living in abundance. You need to get rid of any blocks that you have, that I don't have enough money, anything to do with money limiting you, because you're going to live in abundance now, and it's really just a total game changer. Every day you're going to get more and more abundant. So just keep working on that, and if you have a girlfriend, be careful. She might be fertile. But I think it's more like about money. Let's see. Melina. Oh, intuition. You're working on your third eye, but I could have told you that. Just keep working on eating coconut oil and trying to open your third eye. It will happen. You're going to be able to tell when your third eye is open. I can see it in people in their foreheads. Like, you can actually see the third eye open, kind of like a dent, I would describe it, in their forehead. You can actually physically see it. But I've heard it described like it feels like a metal spoon on your forehead. I can just kind of feel that it's open. Like, feel it. I did have a lot of headaches when my third eye was expanding, so just be really aware of that. Energy healing is really good for that, but when you heal someone's third eye, it makes them sleepy, so just be aware of that. Just keep trying to work on opening your third eye. and you're going to need to rely on your intuition. This card's really for everyone. Everyone should be relying on their intuition all of the time, because ultimately it will save your life in many situations. Robin, happy birthday again. Ha, you're the one making me cough. Throat chakra. Chakra of the day. I could have told you that. I am feeling like a lot of blocks off a lot of you guys. Just keep speaking your truth. When you block your throat chakra, it's because you're not speaking up. For so long, you might have just been letting other people convince you of their opinions, which were wrong. So you were repressing that chakra. Just drink more hot tea, green tea, liquids, and throw some lemon in your water and keep working on the throat chakra. If it continues to be blocked, we will open all of your chakras very cheaply. You can go to sparksofdivinelighthealing.com. That's something me and my twin flame do together, so you really get two strong healers working on you. I'm trying to get to the beginning. And it's really amazing. So I would recommend everyone getting their chakras opened and removing any blocks. Maddie, passion ignited. Well, once you unpack all that crap, I don't know where you're at in the moving process. Once you unpack all that crap, you're at a different new place. You've shifted out of the old and into the new. So you're working very hard. You're going through this moving process and it sucks. But once you get settled in, it's going to be amazing. Your roof won't fall in. This place will be in alignment with you. Everything will be fine and perfect. It won't break. So that should give you some passion. You should be finding your light. That is your passion. We're realizing we don't need to go search in a church for the light. We are that light. If you want some light in your life, you better become that light. That's our job. We're light workers. That's what we do. We are the light. Just try to find out what your passion is. Josh Carson. Oh, I love it. Spiritual union. This is an amazing card. You get the idea. Maybe your twin flame is going to come into your life. Maybe you already have a soulmate. But you're looking at soulmate or twin flame love because they're very spiritual. And usually that is a twin flame. I'm not sure what your relationship status is. If you want, you can PM me if you guys want some more info. But that's really amazing. You're either in a spiritual union or you're about to go into one. And that's really amazing. Hold on, my battery's dying. I have to check it. Okay. Let's see. Lloyd, victory and success with your music too. With every aspect of your life. Things that maybe you were struggling with for so long, you're going to get victory in. That's your music. That's everything in your life. We've been struggling for so long. Well, things are different now. Things are different. Like, we're actually getting to the end. Like, we struggled for so long and now it's kind of like we can write our own ending. We really live in a manifest reality. And you can manifest anything that you want. And we're going to try to manifest happiness. Anyway, I am. I'm going to try to manifest happiness and success. So those are the kind of things we're going to manifest. Let's see. I can't say this name. A-I-H-T-M-Y-C Cilantro. I can't even say it. Obstacles and challenges. We place these on ourselves. We place these own obstacles and challenges on ourselves. We are the only ones who can block these chakras. It isn't the universe doing it. It is us blocking ourselves. So this tells me you just have a few blocked chakras. I'm not sure which ones. You might want to look into having them opened. Let's see. Charlie. Discontent and boredom. You must be living in that 3D paradigm. I feel you. I used to be very bored and discontent. Like I had no satisfaction in my life. I was just bored all the time. Bored, right? Be careful because the universe might give you some excitement. So I will try to find something to do fast so the universe doesn't find something for you to do. You should be focusing on what you can do as a light worker that is service to others. Cameron. Positive movement forward. I want to see you become a doctor so that when I have my healing business, you can help me. Positive movement forward. You have put behind, you're sailing into clear waters. You had a rough past. You just got out of a rough ocean. You're kind of going into the harbor. So things were real rough for you. Now you're going into the nice harbor and you're going to chill. Focus on school. Focus on your future. Because if you work hard at it, you can do anything. Scarlet. Patience and planning. I'm not sure what you're planning. Don't jump into any quick decisions. This is telling me to think very carefully before you make any choices. Don't rush into anything. So I get you're making big changes. Really plan them carefully for them to be successful. Let's see, Jody. Crown chakra. That is your connection to source. That makes my head itch when I hear this. Makes my head itch. So, really, you could probably benefit greatly from having any blocks removed in your crown chakra. You could pray more, and that will help you with your connection with source. That is also most of people, their last chakra that you're going to open. You're usually going to do your third eye and then your crown. I had a profound experience when mine opened after I had an attunement done and some energy healing. So energy healing is something that can really help if you're stuck on these blocks. Let's see, Siobhan, Raj, awareness. This is telling me you need to stop using these two eyes and you need to use your third eye to view things. If you're looking with your eyes, you're always going to be deceived. You really have to start using your intuition and your third eye and your inner knowing to access stuff, to stay really aware of your surroundings. Kimberly. Firm foundation. This is your root chakra. I hate that chakra when people have that one broken. I see really crazy changes, like people can lose their houses, their stability. It's very important that you have a firm foundation, as in secure place where you live at, whatever, or it's going to manifest into the physical and not in pleasant ways. So you have a blocked root chakra. Try to become aware of that. If it's something that persists, I would get a chakra opening. Todd, I don't know if I did you. I'm going to do you again if I did. Financial and material changes. Just really stay on the path. This could be good or bad, but I see it as a good thing. I already told you this, your last card. Just really stay on that path because you're going to see positive results from it. Julia, foundation and achievements. I see the beautiful rainbow. You know, they're looking at the house with the rainbow. You've been on this path, and now you have a good spiritual foundation, and it's starting to pay off. So just really stay on this path. You're doing something amazing. That's a divine rainbow. And work towards peace, love, and harmony. Let's see. Jessica, Lynn. Partnerships and alliances. You're going to work on the relationships in your life. You really need to work on strengthening the relationships that are already prevalent in your life. Work on strengthening things with your family and your friends and making meaningful connections. This is a really good time for friendship for you. Scarlet, new beginnings. That's amazing because I feel like anything that I viewed prior to a year ago was like a past life experience. I kind of catalog it in the same place. And then I started my life really like a year ago. This is my new life. This is my new beginning. And now I can manifest anything that I want. I can control this reality. I couldn't control that last, you know, those last experiences. I can control this. So really just focus on what you want and you can manifest it. Let's see, Nicole. Emotional withdrawal. Well, that's more like a dark night of the soul. You'll get over it. Try to remember that everyone is you, so don't be like upset in any way. Just spend more time alone. Go within. See him meditating on the beach. You need some salt water in your life, number one. So start taking sea salt baths to purify your energy and start meditating. And those are like the best things that you can do. Christine, choose wisely. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He's got like 5 choices. And where does he want to go? Choose wisely. Don't make any rash decisions. Think about things before you jump. Because you don't want to go any of those directions. You're trying to go where the birds are. And all those are the wrong way. All 5. So just really like, don't make any big decisions. You know, don't jump into things. Because you'll end up somewhere you don't want to be. Angela, good morning. Transformation. This is what we're all working at. We're working on self-transformation. I can't control the whole world, but I can work on changing myself while I'm here. I'm trying to go from that caterpillar to a butterfly. I'm trying to evolve. I'm trying to grow. So we're all really working on self-transformation. Just keep working and doing that inner work. Suzanne Richards. Sacrifice. I see the rainbow. We're all making sacrifices. We're learning that we're going to have to sacrifice what I want to do for the divine. That we're having to sacrifice things. You're learning. You're having to sacrifice a lot if you want to go on the spiritual path. I've sacrificed my friends, my family, a lot of things. So I say that the lucky people will lose everything and everyone they ever loved. But that does something amazing because it keeps you free from attachment. So just be aware of that you're making sacrifices now, but you will get it all back later. Martina, material harvest. I love these cards because they're kind of like ascension cards. You are working really hard. You've been on this path and now you're going to get somewhere with it. For so long I've been putting in this work and I'm just now getting somewhere with it. So it can be a little bit like, you know, it's not fast enough for me, but you're really getting there now and things are going to change materially in a good way. Alea, solitude. This is a really good time for everyone to go within and to get in touch with yourself and to meditate. You really have to do a lot of this in solitude. Me and my twin flame, we work different hours, so he's gone during the day. And when he's gone, I'm able to get a lot of spiritual work done. So take advantage of when you are alone and start to do more spiritual work. Mohip, good morning. Power. Well, we're learning how to step into our own true power. For so long, this seems to be a theme of the day. We were giving away our power, and you really want to step into that. How do you do that? You stay pure of heart. You have to be pure of heart to have that kind of power, because otherwise people would abuse it. So you really just want to work on purifying your inner temple. Let's see. Type if you want a card, too. Tammy Austin. Your third eye is blocked from watching this. Wait. Hold up. I'm not giving you a card. Hold up. Your third eye. No. I watch Obama and my third eye gets blocked up. So your third eye is definitely not blocked from watching me in any capacity. I will probably go do some inner work. I don't even want to give you your card. You should probably move on from my video. If anything's making you feel like your third eye is blocked, that's a psychic attack. So I take that a little personal. That's really a psychic attack. That's what happens if I watch CNN. So you should probably move past this video. It's probably not for you in any capacity. If you're feeling that way, that's like a psychic attack. I assure you, that's not happening from my video. I don't want your energy. Because you know what would happen if I did an energy exchange with you? I have to go get it out of my body. I don't think that when I'm taking on this kind of energy, it's not a good deal for me. It's not a good trade. I like my energy. So I'm not trying to harvest anyone's energy watching this video. I wouldn't want that energy in my body. I do take it on as a service to you guys to try to help heal your blocks and your bodies. It's how I can be service to others. But I assure you, I am not an energy vampire and I do not harvest your energy energetically. I have a really good connection with Source and I'm able to draw upon my own energy. I suggest everyone kind of does that. But if you are feeling that kind of like, I guess you would describe it like a pain in your third eye, you're under psychic attack. I would unplug from whatever you're watching and go put yourself in white light immediately. But it's not from me, I assure you. Let's see. Now I'm just like, let me see where I'm at. Yeah, let me know if you want a card. Sorry to get really personal. I do get really like personal on this because this is what I've dedicated my whole life to. So I take it real personal. Stuff like that, as I should. I'm not an energy vampire. I don't want your energy. Tracy, hi! Would you like a card? The Waiting Game? All right, Tracy Lee. You guys are, like, amazing. I love watching your show. And I see amazing things for you guys. I think it's amazing, like, what you guys are doing, the mission you're on, and things are really going to come together. It feels kind of like you're waiting, like, it's like it doesn't happen fast enough. We're working so hard and we're putting in the work and we're becoming so service of others and we're trying to help and we're doing the right thing. But none of this is happening fast enough. It really is picking up intensity and pace, but it's not happening overnight, as you know. So just really keep at it. You guys are an amazing role model. I know you say you're not twin flames, but it's amazing to see twin flames doing this kind of work. And it's really inspiring. So really keep it up. You're on the right path. I'm trying to figure out where I left it off. Cody. Spiritual strength. We're finding that we're not going to get anywhere if we don't have a spiritual strength. Like my body is nothing. Like, if I don't have that spiritual aspect behind me and helping me, I'm not going to really get anywhere. So we're trying to become stronger spiritually now. When you're strong spiritually, you're a force to be reckoned with. You have the whole universe behind you. So just really work on going within and purifying your inner temple. Let's see. I don't know where I am. Carrie, leave if you want a card. Carrie, your sacral chakra. Women use this sacral chakra for manifesting. So when we block it up by being empathic and taking on other emotions and not clearing them properly, it can really just create blocks. And you need that chakra for manifesting and also for like conceiving any kind of ideas or new life or whatever. It's just really important. Study up on the sacral chakra and work on unblocking it. Let's see. Wendy. Heartache and loss. What are you sad about? I feel like you're sad about maybe your past didn't go that great, past stuff. Let it go. My life didn't go as planned, but now it's getting amazing and I can really change it. So I know you have a lot of loss for your past, for past things. Let it go, because you're evolving and you're becoming like a... You're becoming too light for this stuff. You can't have any of this heaviness weighing you down. As you know, it's going to affect your vibration. So just really try to work on letting go of any emotions that aren't serving you. It'll just make you so much lighter. And that involves letting go of our past. Susanna Keating, triumph and success. This is a really good time for you to be to making shifts in your own life. You're going to do anything that you attempt successfully. So I would just jump into that river and see what you can change about your life, because it's a really good time. This is an amazing card. You're going to be successful in anything. You have kind of like a luck shield around you. I would use that to your advantage. Go buy a scratch-off ticket. Jenny. Deception and envy. Well, you're waking up from the illusion of the matrix. Congratulations. That's really amazing. You're learning that there's deception everywhere, that the world isn't what it seems, and it's kind of unraveling for you. Don't be envious ever, because everyone is you, a different incarnation. And just keep your eyes open. You're going to start to have your reality unravel, but it's going to be very rewarding. Let's see, Matt. I love your vibes too, Matt. Hi. Heart chakra. I could have told you this one. I've already told you that before. You're working on your heart chakra, which is amazing, because you were working on your lower two chakras a while ago. So you're kind of moving up, and it's amazing. We need to really have all of our heart chakras open. That is how Tracy's an amazing healer, because she has a very open heart chakra. It's going to make you more powerful. So we're all working on coming from a heart-centered place, and we're working on opening all of our chakras. So just really work on your heart chakra. Be aware of that. And try to love more. Amanda, solar plexus. I think I had them backwards too when I was telling the other one. This is actually when you're empathic. I had them backwards. Whoever's I just did the sacral for, that was the lower one. This one is telling me that you're very empathic. Just be really aware when you're taking on other people's energy that you clear it out of your body. The best way that I can do that would be sea salt in nature. It really will just clear your aura out and detox that energy out of your body. Be really aware that you're telling the difference between like my energy and your energy or other people's. So just be really aware taking on other people's emotions. That's you, Nicole. You're a sponge. Just be really aware of that, because those like bottom three chakras, when they get out of balance, can have really bad effects on your body. So just try to stay balanced. And work on, when you're that sponge going out in public, that you clear that energy out of your body somehow. Let me see where I am. Chris Feel, prosperity begins. I've seen where your daughter's doing energy healing, and it's so beautiful and so amazing. And you have the most like Like, anytime I ever watch one of your healing videos, it's, like, instant uplifting. Like, I can feel myself vibrating. It's really amazing. You're doing really conscious, amazing work. And when you're doing that, when you're living your dream and doing stuff from a heart-centered place, you're going to be prosperous at it. You're going to do good at it. So it's really amazing. Your daughter is going to be an amazing healer, too. Just stay on this path. You're doing an amazing job. Brooke, universe. Well, we're finding out that this universe is really a big place. That it's not as limited as we've been led to believe that we're the only life here and all this stuff. Just really, just look into, like, start studying space and extraterrestrial things because you have a strong connection with it. Let's see. Candace, wisdom. We are all seeking wisdom. That's the best thing that you can be seeking in this life. It's not very good when you seek monetary things or money. We all should be seeking wisdom. We're all trying to learn. We've been learning our whole lives, even if it doesn't feel like it. Even if it feels like we're just floating around. We're learning valuable lessons, and we're trying to tap into that infinite knowledge that we all have in our DNA. So just stay on the path. Keep learning. I know that when you're learning stuff, you get like a high, kind of similar to drugs. It's like a dopamine high. You get like a high off of learning. So it's actually really good for you to learn new things. Let's see. Nikki, emotional loss. Now, unfortunately, the third dimension is very real with separation, pain, any of those kind of grief. I had to go through that too. It can be very painful. Just be aware that that kind of grief is an illusion. When you die, you go to the other realm, which is very accessible. It's very real. It's not like maybe you go to heaven and hell. It's not like you've been taught. So really try to work on opening your heart chakra and dealing with any of that grief. Because you should be expanding your perspective and shifting past those notions and making that pain a little easier to deal with. Let's see. Kate, accelerated motion. I really like this card. It's beautiful as she's staring into space, probably contemplating moving there. everything is happening so fast. I keep saying that, like speeding up, picking up intensity, picking up pace. We're kind of like dealing with the mandala effect and these collapsing timelines and everything kind of getting crammed on us all at once to deal with. So as we're making these little shifts in our own lives, like a lot of stuff's rapidly like occurring that we have to catch up on fast. So it can feel like, I feel like we're going through these storms and I keep getting nailed with all this crap. And then I'll have like a little break and then another storm. So just jump into these storms. Try to take care of anything holding you here, like prior obligations, anything really holding you here, tying you here. Try to wrap up loose ends. Alea, stand your ground. You're giving away your power, possibly in some type of relationship. You really have to learn how to stand up for yourself, but not in like... not in the wrong way. You know, we have to be benevolent, but we have to be kind of like assertive and we have to take control of our lives and our own destiny. Some people like play the victim and it really is a bad thing because you were the perpetrator another life on a deep level. So if we cry about it and play the victim this life, it just makes the situation worse. It's better just to move along. Try to really think about your life and what kind of positive changes that you can make to take control of it. Victoria, destiny. Wow, this is a strange concept, right? Because I love that concept of fate and destiny. But really, what is fate? Because I believe that it's kind of like we make our own fate. We might have these soul contracts that keep us on track. And we might have these programmed experiences that we're going to go through. But really, destiny, I feel like I can write my own destiny at this point. I might have had certain obligations. They're all wrapped up. And it's an open book for me at this point. Same with you. You should be creating your own destiny. I don't like that idea of handing that over and waiting for destiny to be fulfilled. I don't think that will happen. I think you have to jump into it and kind of help that destiny along. So toy with the idea of destiny. Let's see. Oparov, light. As I keep saying, we all have light and darkness inside of us. And it's really about embracing that light and transmuting it from a negative aspect to a positive aspect. We all had to do that within ourselves. I started out with kind of like a negative polarity. I would say I had a very negative polarity. I was very service of self, whatever. And I had to transmute that and get rid of it and change it to light. So you can ascend in the negative capacity, but it makes it very hard later to kind of turn positive. I would try to recommend everyone does that now, because you're going to get to a certain point where you have to be of light. So if anyone else wants a card, type their name. I'm trying to get to them all. Laura. Fulfillment of wishes. Really, and I love this because he's like with the scroll, but he's staring at the money and, you know, kind of like, and there's water around them, which is very important. As you know, water is life with what's going on. Really just try to get a better idea of your future and where you want to go with it, because this is a manifest reality. So what do you wish to or desire? What are your deep down motivations or drives? I would really kind of like look at what's motivating you. Because if it's knowledge, he's holding it in his hands. If it's money, it's kind of in front of him. But if he walks out there, he's about to fall off that leaf. So just be really aware of that. What are your motives? And try to get deep within yourself. Maddie wants a card. Wait. Yeah, type if you want a card. I'm about to go down this list. Maddie wants a card. She's depressed. She's trapped in fear. She thinks her roof's going to fall in her new apartment. you have to get rid of that. Because those fears have been playing out, like with your ceiling falling in. When we have those fears, they will manifest in the physical, in our real life, and they will occur. So you have to let go of any fears, unless you want them to play out in your own life. And I've had every fear I've ever had play out in my life in not that pleasant of a way. So you really have to let go of those fears. They're going to keep you trapped here. So you're probably anxious and stressed out because you're moving. Just jump into it. Get it done. I know it's crazy. There's going to be the holiday or whatever. Jump into it. Get it done. Get rid of that fear. That apartment is so much more high vibe for you. In the end, it's going to be good. You're just in a crazy storm to get there. Let me see. All right. Kelly Jacobs. Conflict and defeat. Well, you're having conflict with yourself, not the world. It might feel like it's the world and you feel defeated, but you're fighting yourself, and you really have to let this happen because you're trying to let the ego aspect of yourself kind of die. So you really have to just let it happen. Surrender to the divine. Know that you're always protected and looked after and cared for, and you don't have anything to be afraid of, and you really just have to surrender. You can't do this on your own. You need that strength. So just really try to get spiritual. And in whatever way that entails. Elson, Allison, suffering in silence. This is another, like, I see Dark Night of the Soul like a common theme today. You don't have to suffer in silence. So you can really tap into that source energy and become spiritual, and you won't be suffering anymore. You can choose to ascend at any point in time. You don't have to keep descending and falling down. You can choose to ascend and come back up. Just try to really get spiritual, go within, and meditate. Let me see. Jessica. Material and spiritual prosperity. I love this card. It can signify a bad or a good change, but this is about to be a good change in your life. You're about to come into some material and spiritual prosperity. So just really stay on the path, and it will pay off in a really big way. Angel. Shadow. We're all working on getting rid of our, transmuting our shadow sides. As I keep saying, we all have light and dark in us, and you really had to become aware of that darkness. It's part of the process. But for every negative aspect that you have, there's a positive one that goes with it. There's a positive reason for it. So that's an illusion, that polarity, that good and bad, even that, oh, I have good and bad in me, is kind of an illusion. So really just tap into yourself. And learn to love all of your aspects. Because with that self-love, you're going to find real love that way. When you can love yourself completely, that's when you're going to find real love manifested in the physical world. Let me see. I'm like going from a weird way. Brayden. Hope. I think it's really uplifting and amazing to think that we all do have so much hope. There's like an angel in there or something. We really do have so much hope. You're a healer. You're supposed to be using your hands to heal. You're going to learn that. That looks like a light ball to me. So really just try to tap into that. It can change your whole life if you can find your mission and your purpose, and you're supposed to be healing others. Chelsea, balance. We're learning how to balance every aspect of ourselves. And I like the card, like these are like the pentacle and the cup and the sword. Those are like the traditional tarot symbols for earth, wind, and fire. We're really trying to balance all of these aspects of ourselves. And every astrological sign has a mix of earth, wind, and fire in it. We're all a mix of these signs. So you're really just learning how to draw upon all of them. If anyone's interested, I do natal birth charts. You can go to my site, sparksdivinelighthealing.com, so you can learn what these aspects are and learn how to draw upon them. Amber, your base chakra, your root chakra. Again, that plays out in, like, maybe you don't have a stable place to live. Maybe you don't have, like, those kind of family roots. Whatever it is playing out, just really look into unblocking your root chakra, because that's probably the worst chakra, I would say, to have blocked. And it's really a good idea just to obviously have these blocks removed. I'm going to let you guys go on that note. I'll be back at some point to broadcast again this weekend, but I'll be for sure back next week. Have a happy Thanksgiving, I guess, with what's going on, or whatever religion you are. Have a nice holiday break if you get one. Take advantage of it. Just try to have a good time, because we're supposed to be having fun. We're not supposed to be living miserably. We're supposed to be uplifting and, you know, having fun, dancing, singing, having fun with our loved ones, whatever. Just try to, like, you know, make the best of things and come from a heart-centered place and work on your relationships, work on speaking your truth, work on those throat chakras, and love and light. Have a good day.